Hit it.
Hip hop and anime have been two of my favorite forms of their respective media types for my whole life. But my love for their intersection probably dates to circa 2005 when I watched the Feel Good Inc. music video for the first time in my cousin's basement, and De La Soul absolutely eviscerated my preteen idea of what music is. See, I was a kid who grew up hiding my love of anime and video games that weren't Halo 3 because being able to sing the whole One Piece 4 Kids pirate rap doesn't really help you make friends at soccer camp. I first really understood the cultural collision that anime and hip-hop have been on when I watched that gorillaz music video, and slowly but surely, the relationship between these two art forms has made waves in global culture. When anime nerds think about hip-hop, series like Samurai Champloo and Afro Samurai are automatic, for good reason. The peak of human culture is in Nujabes' over-animated sword fights, it's RZA and Wu-Tang as the backdrop of Samuel L. Jackson voicing a samurai looking to avenge his father. As a species, we've peaked. We don't really have to make anything else after that. But we have. The influence of hip-hop and its use as the auditory aesthetic in anime has been seen across dozens of series, especially recently, such as the way Devilman Crybaby weaves it into its setting and story, and it's growing more and more widespread every year. It's not just individual characters in major series like Killer Bee in Naruto or Scratchman Apu in One Piece. I mean, hip-hop is slowly becoming a mainstay of artistic inspiration for new anime series. And I'm not only talking about American shows that are firmly planted in the aesthetic of hip-hop, like the Boondocks, but in more subtle ways, the world of hip-hop is starting to contest with traditional Japanese music stylings for scoring anime on a consistent basis. In modern blockbuster anime, we don't just expect to hear Gagaku-inspired music or the sounds of Japanese idols anymore. And I don't mean contest in a bad way, because the harmony of hip-hop and anime is electric. Songs like Rap is a Man's Soul from Gurren Lagann or Showdown from Cannon Busters are genuinely bangers. I listen to them all the time. And it's this influence that allows anime to authentically explore new settings and story directions we probably wouldn't see otherwise. And for me, even more exciting than the influence hip-hop has had on anime is the reverse. The way anime has bled into hip-hop culture and by way of American black culture is really bleeding into mainstream culture here in the United States. The way that black culture, which in my opinion is not only the best pillar of American culture, but the most influential culture in the world, but you know, the way anime has been integrated into black culture has completely redefined our collective relationship with the genre. Over the past two decades plus, the increasing number of anime references in mainstream hip-hop has been so much fun to watch for fans. The same year that the Gorillaz dropped Feel Good Inc., Kanye West released Late Registration, and on the song Touch the Sky, Lupe Fiasco references Lupin the Third in what must have been the first direct anime reference I'd ever heard in a song. And after that, I remember like always searching for more in the hip-hop I was listening to. So I can't really articulate to you how excited I was when one of my favorite artists of all time, Childish Gambino, released the EP, and he dropped the line in My Shine. Honestly, I'm rapping about everything I go through. Everything I'm saying, I'm Super Saiyan like Goku. And then on the same project, a little later on in the song Lights Turned On, he said, my work is my playtime. I need you to understand and to stay fine. Do this and I just might wipe you. Let me poke you, ma. Write you. And this is something that progressively started popping up way more in tons of genres of hip-hop, not just nerd rap. Soulja Boy straight up released a song called Anime in 2011. The same year, Denzel Curry released a song that's laden with anime references called Dark Tournament, the name itself being inspired by the Yu Yu Hakusho Tournament arc. Ski Mask the Slump Gods Catch Me Outside opens with one of my favorite anime lines of all time. Hey, hey, okay. Naruto, Ninetale, Fox, I feel like a Gucci ad-lib bird. Guys, it's so good. And that's not even diving into all the artists who are creating these viral songs specifically about anime. There's been this recent rise on YouTube, Instagram, and TikTok the last few years of artists popping off when they release songs about the hot new anime of the day. A couple that have stuck out to me the last few months are Rustage and Dizzy 8, and just listen to Dizzy 8 go off for a second. They didn't know I'm the one. Stood my ground when they thought I would run. Beat me down when they thought I was done. Being deaf like the sound of my drum. Feel like I can go do what I want. Liberated, man, I come from the worst generation. The influence of anime and rap is massive. And when you start looking back on it, you can see how big of an influence a single anime movie can have with Akira. The influence of Akira is so much bigger than just the bike slide thing we see everywhere now. Akira has been said to be one of the earliest anime influences to what becomes hip-hop culture, with Michael and Janet Jackson's music video for Scream using clips from the movie. And what's probably the most famous example is Kanye West paying an incredible amount of homage to Akira in the Stronger music video, not just with the bike slide and the general aesthetic of the whole video, but the Japanese subtitles throughout. The influence of anime on the modern hip-hop world just can't be understated. From Lil Uzi Vert's K-On! And SAO decorated cars to Megan Thee Stallion cosplaying as Mirko in a shoot for Paper Magazine. Which is just crazy because the My Hero Academia artist actually said she drew inspiration on the character design from Megan Thee Stallion, which is so cool. Ultimate nerd dream is to have a character in a major anime be designed after you. Honestly, the intersection of these two things is just so fucking awesome, and it makes me so incredibly happy. Because juxtaposed with my relationship to anime growing up, music was always an area I felt confident sharing what I liked. So as animation and anime bled into the mainstream, I took every opportunity I could to play songs or videos for my friends that showed more and more how cool anime actually is. I learned I could subvert people's preconceived notions about animation being childish when the production is done by someone who everyone thinks is cool already. My friends wouldn't have watched an animated short about a cute little teddy bear scrambling through a futuristic animal city unless it was a Kanye West video. And I could never get them to watch an anime about a windmill floating through the sky and being attacked by the Air Force, but if it's Gorillaz and De La Soul, it's just incredible art. But now, anime and hip-hop as a combination is ubiquitous in our culture, and that's even created its own set of widely regarded crossover subgenres. I mean, look no further than the internet's favorite lo-fi girl to see how universally adored and popular the combination of Japanese-style animation and hip-hop-style music can be. And this embrace of anime and mainstream culture doesn't just stop in the world of hip-hop. Beyond hip-hop artists, the cultural influence of anime and how accepted in the mainstream it's becoming is showcased by the number of professional athletes who show their love for anime on full display. There's Olympians striking One Piece poses, soccer players referencing anime characters in their goal celebrations, and pregame outfits from NFL players displaying their favorite series.
First swag, Kazekage, leader of the hidden village of the Dead.
I mean, One Piece just had a massive feature at a Rams game, and Luffy was very prominently and very flaccidly featured in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. I think anime is officially cool, guys. And on a personal note, this picture of Myles Garrett before suiting up to play for God's favorite football team literally changed my life. Like, that's no exaggeration. It changed my life. It's not only the moment I decided to start watching Hunter x Hunter, but it's a concrete moment I remember realizing that there's no reason I should be hiding my love of anime. Genuinely, I have to say thank you to Myles Garrett for being such a proud anime fan. Like I said, you changed my life. And also, if you haven't seen this interview where he explains his anime figures to Pat McAfee, let me just do you a favor and play it. It's so funny.
So what's that little, what's a little human looking thing on the left there? What is what
small one?
That love.
Yeah, that one.
Right here?
Yeah.
It's Mob from Mob Psycho.
Of course. I know that.
Those look sick.
So these are all collectibles? Is that what we got going on here?
Yeah, I got a little collection.
Goku's in there, right? There's not a lot of...
Pat McAfee knows who Mob is now. That's wild. But the question I get from all my non-anime obsessed friends is, why do these people who are at the top of their craft, the best in the world, love anime? The influence anime has on people has now started bleeding into our culture as a whole. It's a generation of kids who grew up watching Toonami and Adult Swim, becoming adults and realizing a lot of the truths they learned about life that they saw on a screen in a make-believe world of dragons, balls when they were 10 years old are potentially more authentic than a lot of the world we live in today. There's something about anime characters striving to be the strongest or the best or yearning to accomplish a world-beating goal that resonates far and wide, way beyond the nerd label we grew up with anime having. The influence hip-hop has had on anime is incredible, and it's birthed series that are what some regard as the pinnacle of the art form. But the reverse, the influence anime has had on hip-hop and an entire generation of culture, is absolutely astounding. The relationship I had with anime growing up was uniquely secret. It was between me, my Game Boy, and my TV, and maybe one black sheep kid at the previously mentioned soccer camp who showed me what RuneScape was and told me to search Blue Waffle on my parents' computer when I got home. But for the longest time, my love of anime was just that gorillaz video. It's just a windmill floating in the sky that I probably would never have thought I'd bring down to the land of my real life. But now, thanks to the influence anime has had on one of the pillars of mainstream American culture and hip-hop, my relationship with anime isn't confined to a bubble anymore. Whether I'm watching the NFL or just scrolling through Instagram, I'm gonna see representations of individuals like myself who love anime and wear that on their sleeve. I mean, shit, I'm showing my face online talking about how much I love anime. 11-year-old me would be mortified. The relationship between anime and hip-hop is so incredible. It's so much fun and so exciting for me. I literally cannot wait for the future of anime and hip-hop and seeing where the collection of these two genres will go. There's literally never been a better time to be an anime fan, so jump on board if you're not, and if you've watched all of this, let's go out by watching a few awesome crossovers to end this video. Ew.
Killing me is not enough to kill me, my heartbeat diddy, dee dum dum diddy. I lost four times, I don't give a fuck, I'ma spin back till I get dizzy. It really gets sticky when I switch up gears and get busy. Monkey, monkey, make ops look silly. Mama, mama, got put in a pack, don't cry, I'ma send you to me as swiftly. Why so serious?
Kenchi. Kenka wa mou owari da.
Oi, oi, oi. Kenka wa owari? なめてんのか, Mikey? そんなのてめえの決めることじゃねえだろうが!
I've been in the hills, fucking superstars, feeling like a pop star. Drinking any bad bitches, jumping in the pool, and I ain't got on no bra. Hit her front or back, pulling on the tracks, and now she screaming out no more. They like Savage, why you got a 12 car garage and you only got 6 cars?
Skinny pieces that you clean up with a face, but I love my baby. You talking money, need a hearing aid. You talking money, need a hearing aid.